This right here is the fastest Android ever. Inside this box, I've managed to get early access to the first phone in the world powered by the next generation of chips. You've probably heard of the Snapdragon 888 that's powering almost every 2021 flagship, but this has what they're calling the Snapdragon 8 Gen 1. Super top secret packaging right here. This is gonna be the chip inside your next phone, and it's gonna have 10 insane implications for it. So, thanks to Qualcomm for sponsoring this, and let's dive into an early look at 2022 flagship phones. So number 10 is to do with AI. And I know, AI has been like the industry buzzword for the last 5 years. I feel like I'm becoming numb from hearing it. But this is what you need to know.
For some time now, smartphones have had traditional CPU and GPU cores, but also separate AI cores, which, because they're intelligent, can take some tasks that the CPU and GPU would have had to have used large amounts of brute force to just power through and come up with clever, efficient solutions. And now, with this 8 Gen 1, the AI core is 4 times more capable than that of current high-end phones, which gives it a whole new level of tasks that it can take on. It means that your next phone will be able to understand the context of your notifications and sort them into urgent and non-urgent piles. It'll be able to extract the data from an article online, and before you even click it, tell you if that article is going to have a positive or a negative intonation. The chip even enables real-time monitoring of your voice patterns to be able to alert you if it then detects you have health conditions, like asthma or COVID.
But probably the best example of this AI in action is gaming. Because there is a raw power improvement here. The new chip's CPU is now 20% faster than current flagships. The new graphics core, the GPU, is 30% faster.
Sorry, all this chip talk. I got really hungry.
But the bigger difference you'll notice while playing are 2 sneaky AI tricks. Just for fun, let's see how many times I end up saying AI in this video. See, pretty much the biggest factor in how smooth a game runs is resolution. For every single frame that you see while playing, your machine's graphics cores have had to very quickly figure out what pixel should be displayed where. But the issue is that if you then, say, decide to play in 4K resolution instead of 1080p, you've got 4 times as many pixels that you have to sort. And so, the task multiplies in difficulty. However, with this new chip, your GPU can still perform these calculations at low resolution, let's say 1080p, but then send these 1080p frames to the AI cores, which can then intelligently upscale them into high resolution ones, let's say in 4K. So you can have the smooth frame rates of low resolution gaming, but the crisp visuals of high resolution gaming. And on a similar note, for a game to feel smooth, your phone would normally have to do all these pixel calculations 30 times per second. However, the AI is now crafty enough that instead of having to calculate 30 frames per second through brute force, it can now calculate just 15 frames and use motion estimation, which understands the direction things are moving in, to insert intermediate frames to go in between each real frame. So, this tech alone can double the frame rate of a game. It can turn an unplayable 15 frames per second into a fluid 30. And hey, if a game was already running smoothly, well then, you can instead just take half the workload off your graphics cores and allow the AI to fill in the gaps. You won't realize it's happening until you check your battery percentage afterwards. Now, one of the big themes with this chip is efficiency. You can tell that a lot of the decisions that have been made are implicitly geared around how do we do the same task using less energy? And as well as that being good for just general, well, snappiness, the spin-off effect should also be better battery life. You might know, for example, that every current generation chip is based on a 5-nanometer fabrication process. This one is built on 4 nanometers. It just means that everything has been built on an even more minute scale. Didn't think it could get any smaller. The way I like to think about it is as traveling down a shorter road. If everything is built tighter together, electrons can get to where they need to get to with less resistance, thus reducing energy waste. But it's not just fabrication process. Almost every little section of this chip has had internal optimizations to it. Point is, Qualcomm is claiming significant power efficiency improvements this time around. But given how crazy battery lives have already gotten on phones this year, even if this can translate to just a further 10% boost, this chip might be the one to permanently bury battery woes in the past.
All right, top five. Speaking of the various different sections of your chip, this is your yearly reminder that your phone's chipset is about much more than just power. It's the entire brain. It's responsible for everything from your security to your audio quality. And it's also where your modem sits. Or in other words, it affects your signal. And every single year, Qualcomm has been bumping up maximum download speeds. In 2020, for example, the best chip that you could get supported 5 gigabits per second. In 2021, that was lifted up to 7.5. And now, for phones in 2022, the Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 will allow for, you guessed it, 10 gigabits per second. It is a colossal figure, but not that big of a deal for me. I barely get 5G, and can you even call this a village? So what I'm more excited about is what they call AI antenna tuning, which, how many times have I said AI now? Can boost your range. You know how your phone is lined with antenna bands, right? Like all the way around, you might have 10 different bands to improve signal. Well, the issue is that the majority of the time, depending on how you hold it, you're probably blocking half of them. So, with the Snapdragon 8 Gen 1, the company's figured out a way to figure out what grip the phone is being held in, and then redirect power from the antenna you're blocking to the antenna you're not. 200 IQ move right there.
All right, it's time to talk about cameras. Because every single year, smartphone makers are relying a little less on the physical lenses and sensors, and a little more on the processing of what comes out of them. And so, the single component that's becoming the most significant is no longer the things it used to be. It's the image signal processor, which, hopefully to no one's surprise, is what does the image processing. Well, you might want to get a seat for this. The image processor on this new Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 chip can crunch through not 30% more camera data, or even 100% more camera data. We are talking 40,000% more camera data than current phones. 40,000%. I mean, if this channel grew by 40,000%, we'd have 38 billion subscribers. That's physically impossible. Hey, we can still try. If you enjoy my videos, then a sub to the channel would be quality. The implication of all this being that if more data can be processed, it'll mean that when you take photos, much more information about a scene can be translated to the end image. So that's more detail, better dynamic range, 4 more stops of dynamic range for those of you into photography, more accurate colors, but also probably more as a flex than anything I'd actually use. It's so much data that you know how the iPhone 13 can take 12 megapixel photos, right? This chip gives you the capability to take 12 megapixel photos, 240 times per second.
Hold up.
And this also translates to video. We've seen 8K phones before, but so far there's always been a major caveat, like graininess or poor stabilization. But it's looking pretty likely that in 2022, that won't be the case anymore. The Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 will allow phones to pump out 8K, HDR 10 plus footage, and it's actually recording higher than that. 8K video is about the equivalent of a stream of continuous 33 megapixel photos, but this chip can do a continuous 64 megapixel recording. That's approaching 12K, but what it will end up meaning is 8K with extra room around the edges to be able to crop in and improve stabilization. Oh, also, you know how Apple just came out with that cinematic video mode that was capped at 1080p? Well, this also enables cinematic video at 4K, but we will have to wait and see on how well companies take advantage of that. And then number two, probably the crown jewel of the photography experience, you've heard of night mode, right? When phones spend a few seconds capturing multiple frames and then fusing them together to increase brightness and reduce noise. You've probably also seen some companies labeling their improved versions of night mode as super night mode. Well, the Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 is claiming to bring in mega night mode, capable of fusing together 5 times more frames in the same capture time. This could be amazing.
No, that's definitely too dark.
So what's number one then? Well, all of that cool stuff that we've just talked about is being achieved through the main image signal processor of this new chip. It's actually a triple ISP. It's got 3 cores to be able to process 3 camera feeds at once. But the reason I'm telling you this is that probably the single coolest part of this chip is that for the first time ever, there is actually a secret 4th image signal processor. It's completely separate to the part of the chip that handles camera, it actually sits in the AI section. So to put this another way, this is the first time that your phone's AI can use data from your camera. And what makes this significant is that this fourth ISP has been optimized to use almost zero power, and as such, can be always on. Let me give you an example of what this will mean. So you know how now, if you wanted to use Face Unlock on your phone, you have to double tap your screen or pick your phone up first, right? Not anymore. Because your phone can be constantly assessing camera data, now you just peer over and look. And equally, the second you stop looking, your phone will be able to lock itself. You won't even realize it's happening, but it means that no one else can use your phone. It could actually be the beginning of the end for lock screens. You won't need them anymore. And it even means that if your phone notices that someone else behind you is trying to pry on your screen, it can lock itself down. Cool or kind of scary? What do you think? Let's just check our AI counter. Oh dear. I should clarify, none of this guarantees any particular feature on a phone just because it's using a Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 chip. These are just the tools that Qualcomm is offering to companies. Let's just hope they take them. This right here is the fastest Android ever.
Not anymore.
My name is Aaron. This is Mr. Who's the Boss. Catch you in the next one.